Hi ladies and gentlemen, welcome to ITSnippets. Today I'm going to unbox the cheapest USB capture card that I could find on Amazon Prime. And here it is. So let's get started. So here it is. It's pretty nonchalant, just says video capture. Looks very generic down here, interestingly, you can't really see that in the camera. But it says 1080p out, 4K in. There's not much in the sides, and there's just a little description in the back that I'll read once I get the cover off. So, let's get this open. There's literally no weight to this at all on the back. It says, this video capture can collect both HDTV video and HDTV audio at the same time. You can transmit the audio and video signal to preview and store on your computer or smartphone. Suitable for HD collections, teaching, recording, medical images, etc. Connections connect the UHD signal source and with TE, HDTV, so it'll be with the HDTV, you can tell this is Chinglish. Input of the USB acquisition card through the HDTV cable. Connect the display port with the HDTV outlet and USB. Acquisition card through HDTV cable. Connect USB port to the computer via USB port on the acquisition card through USB cable. Collect operation step OBS. Open the software. Add new source. Select. Click start recording and some specifications. Let's just read the specifications. See if we can get a better view on that. HDTV resolution. The higher the inputs. Can support up to 4K60. Video input format, 8:10, 12-bit color depth. Video output mode, YUV 420 JPEG. Video output resolution, maximum resolution is 1080p. Supported audio format codec, L-PCM. The input cable length, that's just nonsense, standard cable. And size is 66 by 28 by 13 millimeter. Okay, so let's open it up and see what's inside. I actually have Avermedia TV capture cards, and they were quite a pain to get set up. So inside we just have a little bag, and inside that still, we have a even more generic cable. It says obviously made in China. Show you that there. USB on one end, and HDMI on the other. So with that in mind, let's get it connected and see how this works. Okay, I've connected the USB capture card to my system, and I've also connected a Chromecast to the capture card. So according to the instructions, all I have to do is click plus, go to video capture device, give it a name, click OK, and it should give me a choice of devices, which it has. Click on this. There it is, USB 3.0 capture, select that. It's automatically pulled my Chromecast through, you can see that from there. So we will click OK. Now that it's came in, it's taken over a portion of the screen, but that's fine, we can resize that in a moment. So what I'll have to do is I'll have to go into my advanced settings here. And USB capture is coming in over all of the tracks, and I really don't want it on all of the tracks. I don't have anything on track. I basically don't have anything on any of the tracks, so we shall put this on track 2. So I'll just untick all of these boxes and click close. So now the audio should be coming through there. For the purposes of this, I'm just going to move this over the entire screen, so my OBS will disappear, but everything else should be fine. As you can see, it's obviously live because it's just changed the picture. So let's just click on here and drag this out. There we go, that's now full screen. So I shall go full screen here to make it better for you, and I'm going to go to my phone. I'm going to select the Jellyfin app. I'm going to connect to the Chromecast, and it looks like it's connecting. There we go. And I'm now going to try streaming something. There we go.
Okay, so now you won't be able to hear the audio because it's on track two for now, but as you can see, it is picking up the audio. So for the purposes of this, I'm going to click Advanced Properties again, and I'm going to pull this in to track one and click Close. And now hopefully you should be able to hear the audio as well as me trying to talk over it. So this may be a really cheap USB capture card, but that has to be the most foolproof setup I have ever used, and that includes the brand name Avermedia USB capture cards I have used in the past.
If you liked this video, give it a like. If you disliked this video, give it a dislike too. If you get feedback on this or any other videos or suggestions for videos you believe you should do in the future, then please let us know in the comments below. And most of all, thank you for watching.